Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Dipen from Pune, and today I've got this nice 40 liters top box that I'm going to be installing on my TRK. If you guys remember, this was earlier on my 2017 Domi. Very difficult to do vlogs with this mask and all. So in a while I'll be showing you how to install this 40 liters top box on the TRK, how easy it is or how tough it is. And before we move ahead, I'll request you to please subscribe to my channel and do hit the bell icon for all updates on me. So let's begin. So this is the 40 liters that I got from AH Helmets earlier, but now you can find it on the ASD website. Of course, this current box doesn't have any ASD branding, so it is quite good. It can take one full size helmet in it, and I've been using this for around 2 years approximately. So that is the reason why you see the box is not in so good condition. Once it had also fallen off of my 2017 jo gir gaya tha box, because andar jo ye lock aata hai, it is not so strong. That is this one, this lock, is this is not lock and go kind of. You have to fix this on the bike with this nut. So sometimes does go loose, so I'll give you tips how to secure it. But otherwise this box has been really tough. It had fallen down on one of my rides. It has got some scratches and all over, even here you can see. But box did not break as such. Even the hinges are intact after falling. Of course it's dirty because it was last used in my ride in September or somewhere on my 2017 Dominar, and it had drained a lot that time, and that's why it's still dirty. I didn't wash it. So once I fix it on the bike, I'll take the bike for washing and then clean it. So let's begin with the installation. So this is the box, and if you want to see the unboxing of this box, there's a video on my channel. I'll leave links to that in the description. Do have a look at that. So you get this plate along with it. And this plate has this cover, of course. So this you need to fix here, and once it is installed here, you can put the box on top. That I'll show you once I've installed this plate. I'll show you how to install the box on the plate. So first, arrange your plate in such a way that now TRK has these two holes and these two holes over here. Okay, I have removed my indicators. Usually indicators are here. These indicators, they're here. I've removed them from here and I've taken them down. There's a video for that too. You can have a look at that if you want. It's there on my channel. So then these has the top box plate has these grooves. You need to match this groove, so that it comes, it aligns perfectly. You need to match. So if you see the second groove from here, both the places from this columns and this row, it's the second one here, and here too it is the second row and column. Okay, so these two match, and once these two match, the top ones are not matching, of course. So it's not that you need to ignore it. ASG provides these clamps, like these clamps, so you can install these clamps from the bottom somewhere over here. It can be installed here. So in a while, once I figure out how I'm going to do that, I'll then let you know. So I've secured four locations, or I've traced five locations in fact. So the two holes earlier that I showed you, is one is going to be this, second is going to be this, and once I arrange that, this very small hole is also going to be utilized, because that is matching this slot over here. So it will come here like this. Okay, now when installing, make sure that you do not tighten all the bolts in one shot. Okay, you do that one by one. So this is one that I've prepared. This square slot washers come with the top box. You have to secure them here, and this I've used my own, because I don't want to use longer Allen bolts. It becomes difficult for cleaning the bike when you can't put your hand down from here inside, because the bolts hurt a lot. There's very less space here. In my Dominar on the Zana top rack, there was enough space, so long was not a problem. And there's another reason why I'm using smaller ones. I'll show you that in some time. Here's the second set. That also we'll put it here. And ASG will also give you lock nuts. So use these lock nuts only. These are called Nilo lock nuts. So these don't loosen on their own. So use those. So what I did was I installed the nut upside down, nut and bolts. I put the bolt from down and nut from down, from top. Now what is the advantage of this is that if someone is trying to open the nut from the bolt from bottom, this lock nut, after a certain time, it will stay here. I mean, it will become loose, but it won't rotate. It will rotate along with the nut, and thus as the person goes on tightening or loosening the bolt from bottom, unless there's a spanner over here and the nut is getting locked in that, this won't open. So you get an advantage that the top plate and the box that is fitted on the bike, it doesn't get stolen. So this will be one very good installation if you do it this way. Also make sure that the nuts and the bolts are not very long, because you need to fit this plate over here. Okay, you need to cover this top rack, top plate with this the base plate with this cover, so it should not be very long. And now this one I'm going to be securing over here at the bottom. It's on this slot, sorry. Okay, from top I'll be passing an Allen and bolts, spacer washers and all, and at the bottom it will be like this. It will be secured between the two. Okay, there is more to it, do watch ahead. So now the third nut and bolt set is also ready. Again I've used the same slot washer. I've misplaced one, so I've got only three right now, but anyways I don't need the fourth on TRK because I don't see a place for installation. So it's gone inside, and this one I've put in horizontal, these two are vertical. So this will restrict, if you put it in this manner, two horizontal and two vertical, it will restrict the overall movement of the top plate left and right. If you see, it will be, this is still not tightened. And again I've used two of these down here because I wanted it to be a bit more secured, since the weight is going to be on the second half. Okay, all the weight is going to be on the second half, so I wanted to secure it a bit more. So that is the reason why I've used two putties, two of the U clamps from ASG. So you get four of these, and I've utilized two, and two are going to be spare because I don't require this over here. Okay, different top boxes, different top racks will require different arrangements. So this is what is for TRK. Now I'm going to secure it with two more nut bolts, and let me show you that in some time. So the final two fifth bolts have also been put up. I've yet to tighten everything. If you see, this is still loose, this is loose, even this is loose, but the plate has been installed. I mean, it is already not moving right now. Even if I don't tighten this, I'm not able to move this, so it is that secured at this stage. So here I've used again a lock nut. I didn't have lock nuts for these right now. I'll fetch from the market and then replace these. So they're simple nuts right now, but they're good enough because I've added a spring washer in between. Spring washer is something like this, which is cut, a cut washer or a spring washer, you can call call it by different names. So now we just have to make sure that we tighten everything. Now this specific point you tighten at the very end. Why? Because if you tighten this first, the plate is going to sink from the center, and we don't want that. We first want to secure these four locations. So tighten these almost till the end, all four, not completely again, and do it one by one in a tire fashion, on a car wheel fashion, where you do it in a crisscross manner. So this, then this, and like this. It should not be that you have tightened this first and then completely this, and then completely this, and then this. So all the nuts and bolts have now tightened, and we are good to install the top, base plate ka top cover. Now this is going to be a bit tight if your
base plate has gone a bit crooked, but it'll fit. It's not that it won't fit. Yeah, it has installed in an easy manner, and you also have these screws along with it. So these have rusted. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to fetch some new screws for this. If I can, I'll purchase them and put them on this. So with this base plate ka top cover, you at least secure the nuts and bolt partially, and they don't rust and all, dirt doesn't go inside. So this is one good thing. And plus another advantage is that when you're not riding the bike with the top box, this looks neat and tidy. Okay, now let's next step will be just to install this top box on the plate. Top box has got three slots over here, and again three slots over here, notches, slots, whatever you call it. You just slide them into here, in this sort of part here. Okay. Once you see that is secured, open the box, take this lock that they've given. Now for this lock, I'll advise one more thing, and let me show you that. One thing to keep in mind when you are installing, that this hole should be see-through, okay, so that your bolt can go as down as possible. It should not be hitting any of the plates and all, okay, else the bolt will vibrate and it'll damage your top rack, or your or it'll remain loose, and the top box is likely to wobble a lot and then fall off suddenly. So now what I wanted to show you is you add additional of these washers. One will be a spring washer. Why the spring washer? Because we want to create a tension between the bolts, all the washers and all, so that it doesn't loosen automatically. Because otherwise this doesn't have any mechanism to hold it tight. There's no lock nut down there. This will go at the very bottom over here. You need to have this here, because otherwise if you put the spring washers and anything directly on this plastic, it is going to damage the plastic. So let this remain here. And your regular washer will go in here, your spring washer between the two metal parts. Again, the spring washer is not to be on this side. This will be incorrect. Why? Because it is otherwise going to tear off the plastic. So let it be in between the two, and then just tighten everything. So just in case you are riding and you want to take the box off also, this becomes, I won't say completely handy, but it is very useful that you can I try to have a big bag in here and not have the small stuffs in here. So when I want to remove the whole top box, what I do is I lift the bag a bit and unlock the nut and then take it wherever I want. So here we have everything secured, it's completely tightened and it's locked, and then your top box is ready for the bike. Let me just check the vibration levels and all in the box. I'm going to ride inside my society, so that is the reason I'm with this. Please excuse me for. So all installation is done quite well now. I didn't have the issue in a small ride right now that I did inside my society premises. Those who are wondering, where's my 45 liter box? There's it in my car. My car has actually become a dumping ground in this lockdown. So I'll be securing this with bungee also. That is one additional thing that you need to do with some of these top boxes, which are a bit flimsy, but they're good to store and all. So I'll put that, I'm going to put the bungee right from here. It's going to go inside from here, pass from this side, and secure it here so that it doesn't fall off, just in case the nut inside goes loose. So this is one more additional security for the box that I will request everyone to do. And apart from that, I'll do a comparison video sometime after 3 or 4 weeks. Right now I don't have my Explorer, it's gone to Bajaj for the camshaft and since replacement and all. So once that is back, I'll do a comparison video of both the boxes, on one sitting on my Explorer and one sitting on this. So that's it for now. If you guys have any questions regarding this top box, please do let me know, and I'll be happy to answer them at the earliest. Again, request to you guys, do subscribe and do hit the bell icon for receiving all updates from me.
close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And I